Welcome back to VTV Shikshana program. So this is the lecture 6 of module 3 in Digital System Design. So in the previous session at the end, we saw about the difference between the counters and the registers. Okay, so and now we'll take up the concept called register. Okay, so and as you know, registers are nothing but what? A group of flip-flops which are necessary to hold information. So if it is an n-bit register, then it will have n-bit flip-flops and n-bit of information can be stored. So here you can see 4-bit register. Okay, so in typically when I say a register, we predominantly use the D flip-flop. Okay, so you can see each D flip-flop, one D flip-flop can store 1 bit of information. Okay, so you can see that there are 4 flip-flops. Okay, clear? And the common clock is given for all. You can see this. See, this is a clock, and this R is predominantly is the clear. Okay, so when I enable this, when I apply 0, all the outputs, that is Q0, Q1, Q2, Q3, becomes 0. Okay, so I can initially clear my flip-flops. Okay, then on every clock input, depending upon D0, D1, D2, D3, correspondingly Q0, Q1, Q2, Q3 will be enabled or disabled, meaning it will have 1 or 0. So this particular 4 flip-flops, okay, can be considered in a single IC. Okay, so with D0, D1, D2, D3 as 4 inputs, Q0, Q1, Q2, Q3 as 4 outputs, with clear input, which is active low, meaning if you apply 0, then this will be, all the outputs will be cleared. In order to disable this clear, we have to apply 1. Okay, so this is an active low input. And this is the clock now. Okay, so just this is my clock. Okay, input. This is clear. So when I apply logic low, that is 0, okay, clear is enabled, meaning all the outputs, okay, with respect to Q0, Q1, Q2 and Q3 will be cleared. This is what really happens now. Okay, it just clears. Okay, then if I apply logic 1 instead of 0, if I apply logic 1 for this active low input, clear is disabled. Okay, that means now these outputs Q0, Q1, Q2, Q3 depends upon the inputs D0, D1, D2 and D3 correspondingly provided the clock pulse. So this is what I mean. I can have a, this kind of block diagram in which I define, or I can have a 4 D flip-flops to form a 4-bit register. Next, this is another thing, okay, register with parallel load. Okay, so what exactly this means now? Okay, so similar to the previous, we have the clock and the clear input. Okay, so this is my clear, this is the clear input. So you can see that this clear input, which is active low, is given common to all the flip-flops. Okay, once, the moment I make this clear to be 0, yes, all the outputs, okay, that is Q0 will be 0, yes, Q1 will be 0, Q2 will be 0, Q3 will be 0, irrespective of my clock as well as any other inputs now. Yes, this is what really happens now. Okay, that if not, if I make clear is equal to 1, that is if I disable this, because you can see that when I apply 0, this is a bubble, it will become complement. 0 complement becomes 1. Yes, if I apply 1, internally it becomes 0, that means it is disabled. Okay, so the moment I apply clear is equal to 1, internally this clear will be disabled, that is clear of all these, clear or reset, what that's what they call, will become deactivated. Okay, so now Q0, okay, depends upon the D and the clock. Similarly, Q1 depends upon this D input Q and clock. Similarly, Q2 depends upon this D input and clock, and Q3 depends upon its corresponding D input and clock input. Okay, and again you can see that the clock input, okay, is a common to all, meaning all the four flip-flops are triggered or enabled simultaneously. They are in synchronous. All four D flip-flops are in synchronous with clock. The moment clock is equal to 1 means all are enabled. Okay. So now, here are the things now. Okay. So we'll see what exactly this is all about. Okay. So in this particular, this is a register with parallel load, they are saying. We'll see what exactly this parallel load is all about. Okay. So now, this is a combination. Okay. We have AND gate 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Similarly, I have OR gate 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, this is what I am having. Okay. So for AND gate 2, okay, there are two things. Load, this is load bar. Okay, so because it's a complement, all these are complement of load. Okay, these are this, and since this load is double complemented here, this particular column is all about my load. Okay, this is, so this is load, this is complement of load. So this gets, the AND 2 gets D naught as well as load, whereas this AND gate 1 gets the complement and then the Q naught bar, Q naught. Similarly, AND gate 3 gets Q1 and load bar. This is D1 with load, this is load bar with Q2, this is Q3 with load bar. Okay, so corresponding to that. Okay, so this is what really happens. Now, this is a single load. If load is 0, what is this? If load is 0, you can see that the even, the AND gates with the even number 2, 4, 6, 8, the output becomes 0 because one of the input for them is load. The moment load is 0 means what? Output of AND gate 2, 4, 6, 8 is 0. This is 0, this is 0, this is 0, and this is 0. The only reason is this becomes 0 for me. Yes, this is 0, this is 0, this is 0, and this is 0. Okay. Now, we'll come up and see what really happens to the output of the AND gates, which are numbered in the odd 1, 3, 5, 7. So, 1 is what? 1, 3, 5, 7. One of the inputs of all those things are load bar. If load is 0, load bar becomes 1 now. So, this AND gate 1 is nothing but what? One of the input is load bar, which is 1. Okay, this one. This is Q naught. So, Q naught will be the output here. Q1 will propagate here, Q2 will be propagating here, and Q3 will be propagating here. Yes, and OR operation of anything with 0 is anything. So finally, this is Q3, this is Q2, this is Q1, and this is my Q naught, which is my Q naught. When load is 0, yes, this particular Q naught will appear in the same place. Instead of load 0, if I have load is equal to 1, what really happens? The moment load becomes 1 here, so this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, right? When load is 1, the AND gates with respect to odd numbers, they all become deactivated because one of the input is load is 1 means load bar is 0. This is 0, this is 0, this is 0 and this is 0. Whereas load is 1 means this is 1, this is 1, this is 1 and this is 1. And what is the other input for AND gate? So output of AND gate 1, 3, 5 and 7 becomes 0. Whereas output 2 is D0 ANDing with 1 is D0. This is D1. This is D2. This is D3. So at the output of this is D0 or 0 means it depends upon the D0. If I or anything with 0, it will be anything only. Okay. So similarly, it will be D1. It will be D2 and this will be my D3. This is what is happening now. Meaning, previously when load was 0, Q0 was remaining in the same state because that itself was fading. Q0 was Q0, Q1 was Q1, Q2 was Q2, Q3 was Q3. But the moment load is equal to 1 means Q0 will have D0, Q1 will have D1, Q2 will have D2 and Q3 will have D3. This is what I mean by parallel load. Okay. So the inputs are loaded to all the flip-flops simultaneously, that is parallelly. That is what we mean by parallel. So in general, we can summarize when load is 1 means, okay, so inputs, that is D0, D1, D2, D3, are loaded to outputs. Provided clock is enabled and clear is disabled. That's what. When load, if it is 0, okay, then Q0 will be Q0, Q1 will be Q1. Similarly, my Q2 and Q3 will be Q2 and Q3. This is what unchanged it will be. Okay. So this is the way in which you try to give. So this is particularly ensures that this particular OR gate will choose either D0 or Q0. The second OR gate chooses either D1 or Q2. The third Q2 or D2. The fourth the Q D3 or Q3 something. Okay, this is used to pair. Whenever I want a parallel load, I will be having this kind of things. Okay, this is important because we'll come back to this. Okay, in one of the application. Now, the one of the application, as I said, it is used as a register, and we'll see how exactly this register can be. One of the important application of this flip-flop is in the shift register. Okay, we'll see. A register capable of shifting its information in one or both direction. Both direction means left to right and right to left, or in one direction, either from left to right or right to left. And in whenever I am using this shift registers, and this flip-flops always will be in the cascaded form. Meaning, output of one will be acting as an input to the next, output of the next will be acting in subsequently, it will go on. Okay, so this is what it happened. Okay, so when I say serial shift registers, there are four things: serial in, serial out. Okay, so anyhow, so four shift registers are there. One is serial in, serial out, serial in, parallel out, parallel in, serial out, and the last one, parallel in, parallel out. So these are the four significant or different shift registers you have. Okay, the way in which you apply input, the way in which you see the output. Okay, based on the application of the input and the way in which you see the output, the shift registers can be classified into four: SISO, serial in, serial out, serial in, parallel out, parallel in, serial out, and parallel in, parallel out. This is what we'll try to see. Okay, this particular structure, what you are seeing, it is serial input and serial output. In serial input, serial output, you will have one serial input and one serial output. That's it. In SISO, in SISO, that is serial input, serial output, okay, you will have one serial input and one serial output. Okay, serially you are getting the output, serially you are letting the input. Okay, so now this is, for this particular shift in serial in, serial out happens in this case it's one direction. Okay, that means the shifting is happening from left to right. In this way it is happening left to right. Okay, so we'll see what exactly this happens now. And you can see that in a register the clock is common for all, the clock is common for all, and predominantly we make use of D flip flop, and all these flip flops will be the edge triggered flip flop. Okay, so serial in, serial out, since the informations are moving from left to right, my serial input appears at the left. Okay, my serial input appears at the left and my serial output appears at the right. Okay, so this is what, so serial output will be at right side. This is what is all about. Yes, okay, so you can see now this is very important. Now serial in, only one bit information I can input, only one bit of information I can take it as an output using the serial output. So if I consider this as flip flop 1, D flip flop 1, D flip flop 2, D flip flop 3 and D flip flop 4. Yes, so I have 4 flip flops now. Okay, so now this clock is very important for me, right? So I'll try to draw the clock pulses. This is one cycle of 0 1 1 0, this is 1 0, this is 1 0. So 1 0 1 0 1 0 1 and 0, this is 1 and this is, so this is my clock input. Pardon me if this has not come exactly in terms of the way in which it should come. Okay, so this is a drawing. So x-axis will be my time. Make sure that you always write the axis, otherwise it becomes nothing. Okay, clock. Okay, initially clock is 0. Okay, the moment clock is 1, if I say it is a edge triggered, meaning it's a positive edge triggered, means I'm interested in the transition of the clock. I think this will go. Okay, okay, what I'll do is I'll try to redraw. This is 1 2 3 4. Okay, so I'll try to draw my clock input here. This is one cycle, this is two cycle, three cycle and four cycle. Okay, I'm worried only between 1 0, 1 0, 1 0 and 1 0. Okay, each combination of 1 0 is nothing but what, my clock cycle. Okay, this is one clock cycle. Now you can see that in the first clock cycle, the moment the first clock cycle, this is my first clock cycle, this is my second clock cycle, this is my third clock cycle, and this is my fourth clock cycle. Okay, when the first clock cycle comes, okay, all the flip-flops are triggered simultaneously. Yes, all the flip-flops. So initially what we do is, before I apply clock, okay, assuming there is a reset or clear, it is not preset, it is reset, or I just specify clear CR. Okay, that will be okay for you everyone. Now I enable this clear and ensure all the flip-flops outputs are 0, and then I disable this. Okay, I enable the clear input to ensure outputs of each flip-flop is 0 0 0. That means each flip-flop is reset to 0. Okay, then I will apply my first clock pulse. This is one. The moment the first clock pulse is applied, all the four flip-flops are enabled simultaneously. Make sure that for the first D flip-flop, I have to apply the serial input externally. For the second serial D flip-flop, output of the first flip-flop acts as an input. For the third flip-flop, output of second is acting as an input to third. Output of third is acting as an input to the fourth. Okay, so no need of applying inputs for flip-flop 2, 3 and 4. I need to apply only for SI. Is this clear now? So now what I'll try to do is, so initially my flip-flop contents are 0, 0, 0, 0. This is what initially happens now. Okay. Yes. Next. After the first clock appears, I am interested in the positive edge of the clock. That is the meaning. The transition of the clock happens from low to high. That edge. The moment the first clock appears, my serial input, I will let it to be 1, logic 1. Okay. Yes. When this is enabled, when the D input is 1, obviously the output of this will become 1. And since flip-flop 2, 3, 4 are simultaneously triggered along with this, input for flip-flop 1 is 1, input for flip-flop 2 is 0, which is the output of first, input for 3 is 0, input for 4 is 0, right? So, input of, you know, the output of 2 becomes 0, output of 3 becomes 0, output of 4 becomes 0. Yes. In other words, output of first is going to input of output to this after the first clock pulse. It is nothing but what? It is something happening like this now. Shift. It is shifting one bit at a time. And what is this? This is the serial in. This is my serial in. Okay. This is the first flip-flop output. This is the second flip-flop output. This is the third flip-flop output. This is the fourth flip-flop output. Okay. This is initial case. Initially, I have cleared all the flip-flop. That's why it is 0, 0, 0, 0. Okay. The moment I apply the first clock pulse, my serial input is 1. And the input for second is 0. Output input for third is 0. Input for 4 is 0. Yes. The moment the first clock pulse comes, serial in goes here as output. The output which was there here, that will go as an input here, like this. Yes. Next. When the second clock pulse comes, okay, I let the serial input to be 0 for the second clock pulse. Okay. So that means all the flip-flops are triggered simultaneously. Yes. Flip-flop 1 is getting the input 0. Flip-flop 2 is getting the input 1 because output of this is now 1, right? Yes. So this will get 0 and this will propagate to the next flip-flop, that is the output of second. Sorry, this becomes 1 here, sorry. This is 1. Yes. This will be propagating here to the third and this will be to this now. So now my first serial in is at flip-flop 2 output after 2 clock pulse. For the next clock pulse, I ensure serial in is still 0. Okay. After the next clock pulse, I know that this will get 0 and this will propagate to the next flip-flop. This will propagate to the next flip-flop and this will propagate to the next flip-flop. So next, when I come to the fourth clock cycle, again, I let my serial input to be 0. Okay. And the corresponding inputs of 2, 3 and 4 will be 0, 1, 0. So after the fourth clock pulse, since serial in is 0, this will get 0. Since the input was 0 over here, this will be 0. This will be coming here. And this 1 will go as this. So you can see that the first serial in to come at the serial out, the first serial in to appear at the serial out, I require 4 clock pulses in serial in, serial out. Meaning, if I use a serial in, serial out, it is from, in this case, it is left to right. In the similar fashion, you can do it from right to left. It is one direction only. Yes? If here I have used four flip-flops to form a shift register, so I require minimum four clock pulse for the first serial in to appear at the serial out. Okay? I require four clock pulses for the first serial in to appear at the first serial out. If I have n flip-flops or n shift registers, n bit shift register, then I require n clock pulses for the first serial in to appear at the serial out. And next subsequent will come immediately after the one or the other. Okay, so this is how it happens now. So initially, my flip-flops output were all zero, cleared. Next, you know that this is acting as an input to the second, this is acting as input to third, this is acting as an input to fourth. The fourth will go, yes. After the first serial line, I got something like this. Because I had kept the serial in to be 1, right? I had kept the serial in to be 1. So after the second clock pulse, I let the serial in to be 0. That's why this was 0 and this was propagating over here. It is something like in the diagonal way, I will be getting my 1s and 0. This is about your shift register, that too in serial in, serial out. Okay? Flip-flops are in cascaded form. In any shift register you take, the flip-flops are in cascaded, meaning output of 1 is driving the other. Output of second is driving the third. Output of third is driving the fourth. Okay, this is what is happening. This is shift register, that to serial in, serial out. Yes. Next, before going to the universal shift register, okay, so either you can, okay, so universal shift register, typically what happens is in a serial in, serial out, I can perform in only one direction, either from left to right or from right to left. Okay. Even I can have a bidirectional. Okay. But universal shift register is one which will perform all kind of shift action. That means I can perform serial in, serial out. I can perform serial in, parallel out. I can perform parallel in, serial out. As well as I can perform parallel in, parallel out. This is all I can do using this universal shift register. Okay, capabilities. A clear control to set the register to 0. One input is there. This is a synchronous input. A clock input, shift right control, shift left control, because I have to perform both direction. N input lines, a parallel load control. Because when I say parallel load means, as we saw earlier, all the inputs are loaded to the flip-flop simultaneously. That's what I mean by the parallel load. N parallel output lines means, when I'm saying parallel output means simultaneously I have to take the output of all the flip-flops. So that's why this N parallel output lines, a shift control. Okay. So I need one more, that is shift control. These are the important capabilities the universal shift register should have. A clear control to set the register 0 at the clock input, shift right control, shift left control, N input lines, a parallel load control, N parallel output lines and shift control. Okay, this is what I am having now. Okay, we'll see how exactly this works now. Now you can see that. Again, I am taking the 4-bit register. Universal 4-bit shift register, okay. Yes, this is what I have. You can see that clear input is common, clock is common to all the flip-flops are triggered simultaneously. Along with this, I use a combinational logic called the multiplexer. If I have 4-bit shift register, I require 4:1 mux. If I have n-bit shift register, then I should have n 2 to the n 1 shift register, okay. Sorry, mux I should be having. Okay, this is very important now. Okay, now we'll see how exactly this works now. Yeah, now S1 and S2 will control the selection. Okay, what exactly it happens? You can see that each multiplexer will have 4 inputs. Okay, if I have n bit shift register or n bit n flip-flops, then I require n is to 1 multiplexer. Okay, so this is, but here, since I have ensuring it is a 4 is to 1 mux, because I am worried only with respect to the 4 operations, right? So that's why I require, since it is a universal 4-bit shift register, I require 4 such 4 is to 1 mux. If not, if I have n-bit shift register, then I will have n 4 cross 1 or 4 is to 1 mux. N such 4 is to 1 mux. Okay, this is what I'm having now. Yeah, that's what. Now, again, S1, S2, S0, S2 become control signals for us. Okay, what I will try to do is S2, S1. The moment there are two variables means I can have four input combinations. 00, 01, 10 and 11. We'll see what exactly. When both are 00, 0 is connected. Yes. A3 is this. A2 is this. Okay. So, the function, what exactly I will be performing in this particular shift register. Okay. So, I am doing nothing. Okay. Nothing I'll be doing the moment S2, S1 are 00. Okay. We'll see what exactly I mean. When you see, you can see that when S2, S1, 00 and S2, S1 are common for all, same S1, S2 is going to all the flip-flops now. Okay, S1, S2 are common for all. Yeah. If I apply 00 for this, the same thing appeared out here. When I apply 00, you can see that A3 is the output of third flip-flop. This is 2, this is 1, this is 0. You can call this as something like Q3 only, I don't mind. This is Q3, this is Q2, this is Q1 and this is Q0. That's it. Okay, I'll put it in this bracket, okay. Right? So, A3 is selected to 0, here A2, A1, A0. And the output, when S1 and S0 are 0, 0, it is A3 of this is acting as an input for this. You can see here, see A3, here it is A2, because this 0 is the output here. Whatever I am loading to 0, that itself is the output. The 0th input is nothing but what selected at the output now. Yes. The 0th input selected out there. What is here? It is A0. See? Simple. This is A0. This is A3. This is A1. This is A2. This is A1. And this is A0. This is A0. Right? This is A0. Right, simple. Right? And since 0 is selected at the output because of the select line, so A0 will. So A0 is again, this is storing simply A0. This is simply storing A1. This is simply storing A2. And this is simply storing A3. That's why it is doing nothing. Okay, when both S2 and S1 are 0, 0. Now when S2 0, S1 1. When S2 0 and S1 1. So what I am selecting? This is what selected at the output, right? Yes. So that's what we'll try to do now. So when both are 0, 0, they are doing nothing. Now, when this is S1 is 1 and S2 is 0, 1 is selected at this output. Similarly, 1 is selected at this output. Similarly, this one is selected at this output of this mux, and similarly, this is selected. This is selected, right? Now, what is this basically? This is serial input for shift right. So, now I am performing something called, we'll see what exactly I mean by 101. What is 1? This is serial in, right? whatever this is coming, serial in, that is itself is coming now. So whatever the value this serial in gets, that will be there for A3. Yes. Now you see what is connected to A1 now. Sorry, the first input of the MUX2. This is, I'll go with MUX3, 2, 1, 0. You can see that this is connected to what? A3, see? A3, that is output of this. And what is this connected? It is A2. And what is this? This is A1. That means this is connected what? A3. This is A2. And this is A1. See now? This flip-flop is connected with serial in. This flip-flop is connected with A3. This is connected with A2. This is connected with A1. This is similar to serial in and serial out with respect to shift right that we did previous case. Yes, that's it. Next, if I try to give the clock input, okay, again, for the first clock pulse, whatever the serial in is there, that will be there at this output. And whatever the output was there, that will come here now. That's it. So it will be acting as a shift, serial in, serial out with respect to shift right when S1, S2, S2, S1 is 1, 0. So when S2 and S1, when this is 0 and this is 1, okay, what function this particular universal shift register will be doing? It will be doing shift right, that too with respect to serial in, serial out. See, only reason is we have already seen 4-bit shift register with one of the flip-flop input is serial in and the output of the first is fed as a second input. When the output of second is acting as a third flip-flop input and when the output of the third is acting as a fourth input, okay? And this is where I am doing it. A0 is my serial out. This is my serial out, see? This is serial out. Clear? This is my serial out. This is serial in, serial out with respect to shift right. So whenever S2 is 0 and S1 is 0, I am performing serial in, serial out with respect to shift right. Done. That is the function. When both were 0, 0, I was doing nothing because each flip-flop were storing their own previous value. A3 was storing A3, A2 was storing A2, A1 was storing A1, and A0 was storing A0 only. Okay, this is shift. Now, I'll go with the third possibility of S2 and S1, that is 1 and 0. We'll see what function it will be doing now. Yes. That is S2 is 1, S0 is 0. That means 2 will be selected to the output of each multiplexer. You know what exactly a multiplexer does. It will select one input among many inputs, right? 1, 0. 2 is selected here. 2. But what is 2? 2 is selected. What is 2 here? It is A2. So this is A2. What is this 2? This is A1. You can see that. And what is this? This is A0. For this 2, I am saying. For this 2, this is A0. And what is coming to this 2? It is serial in. See, this is serial in. Since it is 0, 1, serial input is gone to this particular one. What is going here? This is A0. What is coming here? This is A1. What is coming here? It is this A2. You can see that now I am giving the serial in not to the leftmost flip-flop, but I am giving to the serial in for the rightmost. Yes. This is 0, 1, 2, 3. 4 flip-flops are there. The 0th flip-flop getting serial input. The first flip-flop is getting the 0th flip. So A0 is cascaded to the next. Output of the second is cascaded to the second. Output of this is cascaded to the next. Okay. And this is where I'll be taking my serial output now. This is again SISO, but now the what is the shift? It is the shift left now. Is it clear? It is performing a serial in, serial out with respect to shift left operation. The serial in is given to the rightmost flip-flop. Serial out is taken at the leftmost. Here also, I require 4 clock pulses for the first serial in to appear at the serial out. If it is an n-bit shift register, then I require n clock pulses. Okay. So with S2, S1, again I am performing shift operation, but with respect to the shift left here. Is it clear though? So when both S2, S1, 0, 0, I was performing nothing. When S2, 0, S1, 1, then I was performing shift right. And when S2, 1 and S1, 0, I am performing shift left operation. Hope this is fine. This is what. This is the function I perform. Next, the last option I am left with, S2, S1. And what is the function that will perform? Okay, when both are 1-1. When both are 1-1, that means all the flip-flops inputs are, select lines are 1-1 means, this 3 will go as an output here. This 3 will go as an output of the MUX. This 3 will go as an output for this. And this 3 will go as an output for this. The only reason is the select lines are 1-1 here. Yes. That means what is connected to 3? Parallel inputs. This is something like P3. This is something like P2. This is something like P1. And this is something like P0. What comes here? It is P3 comes. What comes here? It is P2 comes. What comes here? It is P1 comes. And what comes here? It is P0. Yes. The moment I apply the clock pulse, okay, A3 will be loaded with P3. Simultaneously, A2 will be loaded with P1. Simultaneously, A1 will be loaded with P1. And simultaneously, A0 will be loaded with P0. Meaning, when both S1, S2 are 1-1, provided clock, all the flip-flops will load whatever the inputs each flip-flop is having. Okay, so each flip-flop will be loaded, all the flip-flops will be loaded simultaneously with the corresponding input. So A3 will get P3 after the clock pulse, A2 will get P2, A1 will get P1, and A0 will get P0. Okay, this is what I am. This is what really. So S2, S1 is nothing but what? Parallel load. Okay. So 4 functions are done now. Okay. So which are those 4 functions? I'll just try to summarize here. S2, S1 function 0, 0, do nothing. It just loads the previous one. S2, 0, S1. It is shift left I am performing. Okay. When it is 1, 0, I am performing shift right. Shift left means flip-flop A3 will get the serial in. A0 will be the serial out. Shift right means A0, this flip-flop will get the serial in. This where I will be getting the serial out. 1-1. I'll be doing the parallel load. This is the combination I have. Okay. I'll see whether I can have a, 0-0, there is no change, nothing I'm performing. 0-1, I'm performing shift right. 1-0, I'm performing shift left. And 1-1, we are performing the parallel load. Yes. That's what we are doing now in this case. Now, I can perform anything now. So now, suppose I want to perform serial in, serial out. With respect to shift left means, I have to just make sure S1 is 1, this is 0. Yes, serial in will be connected to this. For this, A3 will be connected, this input. This will be connected with A2, and this flip-flop input will be connected with A1. And this is where I'll be taking my serial output, serial in, serial out. Yes. If I want to perform serial in, serial out with respect to shift right means, I have to ensure that this is 0, this is 1, this select lines. The moment I do this, okay, what will happen? 2 will be selected here. What is 2 basically? It is A2. So this will be getting A2. this will be getting A1, this will be getting A0, this will be getting serial in with respect to this, because 2 is serial in C. So this will be serial in, this will be my serial out. Again, 4 clock pulse. Yes. The same serial in, serial out, I can perform serial in, parallel out now. Serial in, parallel out. Serial in, serial out means one input, one output. Serial in, parallel out means input will be one at a time. Parallel output means simultaneously I'll be checking the output. Okay. For example, if I go with serial in, serial out only. So for the very first clock pulse, this serial in, whatever is there, it will go at this output. And whatever is there, it will go at this output. Whatever is there, it will go at this output. And whatever is there, it will go at this output. Okay. The first serial in is now at this point. Yes. After the next clock pulse, this SI will come here. The first serial in will come here. The second serial will appear here. Okay. This will be still previous. So this will still appear here. This will. After the third clock pulse, this will get the third thing. This will get the second serial in. This will get the third serial in. The first will be here, 2 and 3. This will be the previous. After the fourth clock pulse, the first serial in, which was here, it will come here. This will be having the second serial in input. This is will be having the third, and this will be having the fourth. So now, after fourth clock pulse, the first serial in is appearing at A3, the second serial in is appearing at A2, the third serial in is appearing at A1, and the fourth serial. So I can see that 4 clock pulse are required for all the 4 flip-flops to get the serial input, okay? And now, after the 4th clock pulse, I will take the output simultaneously, that is parallel output. That is what? Serial in, parallel out. What mode I will be using? Either I will be using S1, serial in, serial out with respect to shift left or shift right. And only after the 4th clock pulse, I will check all the outputs with respect to A3, A2, A1, A0. That is what I mean by the serial in parallel out, whether it is shift left or shift right. Okay. So we did 3 now. Serial in, serial out with respect to left, serial in, serial out with respect to right, serial in, parallel out. Yes. Okay, next. If I want to perform parallel in, serial out. This is very important now. This is very important. Parallel in, serial out. Parallel input means parallel load. So what is the function? If I see the function here, in order to do the parallel loading, what should be my S1, S0 control? Here it is S1, S2, that's it. Both should be 1-1. When it is 1-1, all these will be loaded parallel. This is P3, this is P1, this is P2. Then this is P3. This is what I mean by I have to make use of 2 control function. One, first to load parallel input 1-1, it will load. Okay. So that means this is P3. After the first clock pulse, each flip-flop will hold these values. Yes, this is P0. So for the first clock pulse, before the first clock pulse, make sure that your S1, S2 is 1-1 so that I do the parallel loading. Okay. So before the next clock comes, make sure that whether you are doing parallel in, serial out. Serial out with respect to shift left or shift right, that depends upon this. If I do this, it will perform shift left. Okay. After the first clock pulse, this will be my serial out. After the first clock pulse, first serial out is coming. Then the next serial out will be coming with us. So this will be going here. It is shift left. This next it will be coming here. Next it will be coming here. So again, I require 4 clock pulses for these outputs to appear as the S0. This is what I mean by parallel. In the parallel serial out only, the function control, first I have to load. In order to load, I have to make 1-1. Then in order to get take the serial output either at A3 or at A0, make sure you provide either 01 or 10. Okay. Only for parallel and serial out, I require two control functions. First 11 and then followed by 01 or 10. Then the last one, parallel in, parallel out. This is very simple for me. The moment I use 11 for parallel load, whatever P3 is given here, P2 is given, P1 is given, P0 is given. I require only one clock pulse for all these to appear at their corresponding outputs, P3, P2, P1, P0. So this is the parallel output. Take simultaneously. In the previous case, I was taking at only one flip-flop output. So that's why I used to have shifting and then taking. But in this, load parallelly and take the output parallel means only one clock pulse. Okay. After the first clock pulse, all the inputs are loaded and I get the parallel output. So that is what I mean by parallel and parallel. So that's why this becomes a universal shift register. I can perform the shifting operation one bit each towards right or left simultaneously, one at a time, or I can perform parallelly also. Okay, so I can perform SI serial in serial out with respect to shift left, I can perform serial in serial out with respect to shift right, I can perform parallel in serial out. Only for parallel in serial out, I should make sure first load and then use the control S1 S0 or S1 S2 with respect to shift left or with respect to shift right. Yes, and then parallel parallel out, only one clock pulses. So except PIPO, for the remaining all, I require four clock pulses if I am using a 4-bit shift register. If I am using an N-bit shift register, I require N clock pulses for SISO, SIPO, PISO. For PIPO, it may be any bit shift register, I require only one clock pulses. This is all about my register that to shift register application. And this is what. And predominantly, I'd use this as S1 and this as S2. Okay. You can just, no problem. Either you can change in that block diagram or I can change in this. Okay. So this is what. This is about your shift register. Okay. So we'll take up the counters that to asynchronous or what we call it as a ripple counter in the next section. Thank you.